introduce yourself.
Thank you for giving me this opportunity to introduce myself. I am Anshul Gupta. I live in Indore. I completed my secondary education from Keshav Government School. I am graduate in BCA from Chamradevi Group of Institution. Currently, I am pursuing iOS app development from Shiva Concept Solutions.
Okay. What is the main difference between double equal operators and triple equal operators?
Double equal operator is for condition check, मतलब equality check कर दो. Triple operator.
You not use triple equal to operators?
No, in Swift not use.
Okay. Object comparison, I think that if you are compare the reference, then you will use triple equal to. If you are compare the value, then you will use double equal operator. What is force unwrapping?
Force unwrapping in Swift with exclamation mark.
Why we force unwrapping?
To capture the value from optional type values.
Okay, because it is by default, right? Optional. Okay, so we want to emit this keyword. That's why we will implement it. But their reason is that. Okay. The next one. What is the main difference between enumeration and structure?
Enumeration is a data type which is a common value.
Okay.
And structure is a collection of variable and functions.
Means structure can contain different type of value.
And enumeration is a common type values.
And what is the main difference between class and structure?
Structure is a collection of different types and class is a collection of data member and member function.
Okay, and any other differences?
Yes.
What we can't do using a structure, this is only possible by class.
Structure is immutable, whereas class is a mutable.
Okay.
And structure is a value type and whereas class is a reference type.
Okay, any other differences?
Any other differences? Instance of structure can be one only. And
class can different instances.
Many instances.
Constructor is possible on structure, means init method is possible in structure?
Init method, yes.
Is it possible?
Nahin. Init ko contain karta by default structure.
Okay. And class?
Class not contain by default initializer, but we have to declare a initializer.
Externally. Inheritance supported by the structure?
No.
It's not supported.
Only for protocol.
Only for protocol
inherited in structure.
We can access enumerations under structure?
Enumeration in, yes.
You can access this?
Yes.
Okay. What is the closures?
Closure is a self-contained block of functionality that can be passed and used in our code.
Okay. Means, suppose that I want to create multiple closures. Okay. And I want to access these all closures into the class. Is it possible?
Is it possible?
How?
Using their variable.
Yes. And we can declare closures inside of the class?
Yes.
Is it possible?
Yes.
Inside of the structure?
Inside of a structure. Structure mein kar
sakte. Inside of enumerations?
Enumeration mein bhi kar sakte.
Okay. Means anywhere.
We can use.
And you can tell me the most important features of OOPS.
OOPS ke most important feature object ho gaya.
Only class. One most important features of
must only one.
Yes.
Object and class.
Object and class. It's the compulsory class. Features, I think.
It is compulsory feature.
I am asking most important features, means most beneficial features.
Inheritance.
Very good. What is the fall-through statement?
Fall-through statement is used in switch where we can call next case of switch statement.
Okay. Means call next case of switch statement. Switch means.
मतलब जैसे मतलब case one और case two है. यदि अपन fall through लगाएंगे case one में तो case one का statement भी print
करेगा
और
case two
का भी.
Means if we want to disable the break statement.
हाँ.
You can simply say that.
Simply say.
Okay. What is the small refactoring of the code?
Small refactoring of code.
What is the meaning of refactoring?
Refactoring, modifying.
small refactoring. Refactoring means होता है partitions. If you want to create the partition means brackets.
Opening bracket.
Curly brackets. That is called refactoring.
Okay.
If else, it is mandatory to refactoring the code.
हाँ.
But in other language, it's not.
Not mandatory. Mandatory.
Okay. That is called refactoring.
Refactoring.
Okay. What is OPQ type?
OPQ type.
Yes.
OPQ type in shift from 5.7. It is a new release which we have to return a value with without return keyword.
Okay. Means without return statement you can return.
You can keyword. Return the
keyword. Okay. How to declare constant in Swift language?
With let keyword.
Okay. Let keyword. Suppose that let can be declared globally or locally.
Both.
Both it can be declared.
Both.
So same identifiers we can declare global and local.
Identifier is a
same identifier. Suppose that I am declaring global let A and local let A.
Hmm.
Both will work?
No.
It's not will work. Why?
Because of same tana.
I think that their accessibility is
case sensitive. Nahi ka.
Their access will their scope will be the different na.
Ha, scope is different than
I think that
drive.
Will work.
That's
okay. Multiple init method we can create in class?
Yes.
Is it possible?
With over no. Only for default and parameterized.
No, in single class.
In single class,
we can create multiple init method or not?
Not.
We can't create. No. In single class, one init method will be there.
But default and parameterized. So
yes, the multiple init method we can create.
By
suppose that we will inherit class A init method, class B init method, and class A inherit class B inherit class A.
Class A.
Okay, then what happened in the class A init method? It will be exist or it will override by class B method?
Override init by B class.
It will automatically override. I want to call A class init method and B class init method both. Then what I will do? I want to call A and B both class init methods from B class.
From B class.
Then what you will do?
Super dot init for A class.
Yes, yes.
Super dot init for A class.
Okay. That's good. You should little bit improvement in your skills. Okay. That's otherwise your communications and your representation skills both are good. Okay.
Thank you, sir.